last question. Never think of consequences. I didn't feel a thing. I didn't feel a thing. I never think twice, no intentions. Never feel the consequences. Until it starts to sting. Until it starts to sting.
Hey guys, Agent Ghidorah here. Happy Thanksgiving and welcome to the final matchup of the Monster Arena. Now, I know this might be weird. Legendary, the Monster Hunter? Really? Isn't that like an OC, an online character? Well, yes, but again, they still have feats. So, we'll be using Monster Hunter from Monster Hunter's Generations until Monster Hunter World. I have not played or watched anything from Monster Hunter Rise because I want the full game, you know, to play through, play out, and well, I researched all the monsters, and, you know, I played the games myself, so, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please comment, like, and subscribe, and share with your friends. Also, happy Thanksgiving to you all, and hope you are having a safe day during this pandemic. Now, let us begin. The Monster Hunter is your OC character, or online character, from the Monster Hunter franchise. Believe it or not, they are actually incredibly powerful. So without further ado, let us begin. The Monster Hunter, or the Hunter, as I'll refer to in this entire video, is incredibly strong. Actually able to stagger skyscraper-sized monsters like Dalmador, a monster that can shatter mountains and shape entire continents just by moving. Gammoth, one of the few Elder Dragon-classed monsters, and being able to stagger and even knock out monsters like Nergigante, Teostra, Lunastra, Kushala Deora, and even the likes of Rajang and Devil Joe. The Monster Hunter is also incredibly durable, even taking attacks from these monsters, even being poisoned, burned, electrocuted. You know, you guys get what I mean, right? Even taking dragon energy, which is, again, a continental level energy status, okay? He's able to take attacks from even the strongest monsters around and actually is able to brush them off. The Monster Hunter is also incredibly fast, being actually able to react to monsters that move at Mach speeds, like the monster Valstrax, and even able to monsters that can actually move at faster than light speed. Things like Rajang's lightning blast or Kieran's lightning blast, okay? Hold on. Ooh. Even blocking the flash of light from the TTTC monster from the Coral Highlands, okay? He's able to block the flash of light from that monster, all right? Now, with weapons, I'm going to actually use the Insect Glaive today because, one, that'll actually balance out the agility factor. The Insect Glaive or the Insect Blooming Glaive or whatever glaive you guys want is pretty much one of the most powerful or one of the most athletic weapons in the Monster Hunter franchise. You're actually able to do flips, agility dodge around monsters, even use it to grapple on top of monsters and stab them. It comes with a variable thing, so today we'll be using the Blooming Glaive, which actually allows the user to pretty much poison its opponents, okay? Able to poison its opponents, and over time, wear them down. So yeah, that's the Hunter. Plus, they also come with armor. Today we'll be using the Gammoth armor, which would scale to the Gammoth himself, being able to take attacks from monsters like Tigerex, Devil Joe, even other Elder Dragon class monsters, alright? Gammoth is even confirmed to be an Elder Dragon class monster, even though for a fanged beast, it's incredibly powerful, alright? So yeah, that's the armor we'll be using today, and I hope you guys, you know, really like it, alright? I love it, okay? But in the other corner, Spider-Man. Today we're using Spider-Man from, well, like the title says, the PS4. So this Spider-Man, this Peter Parker, is actually just one of the few Spider-Man in the Marvel multiverse. So really, it's really no different here from any other Spider-Man, right? Well, he's been bitten by a radioactive spider. We should already know that. This Spider-Man is incredibly strong. Actually, he's able to stagger and knock out Rhino with his blows. Actually, he's able to lift cars. Actually, he was confirmed to stop a train before, and that's a locomotive train. So that means this Spider-Man will be able to stop at least 212 tons of train. He's even been able to stop trucks, semi-trucks, and even was able to lift an, I think it was a oil tanker. Yeah, so an oil tanker truck. So yeah, that's pretty impressive in my opinion. This Spider-Man is also incredibly durable. Actually, he's able to resist Mr. Negative's corruptive touch, take poison from Scorpion, electric blast from Electro, the quills, I think we call it quills, or the metallic feathers of Vulture, a beating from Doc Octopus, and being pretty much beaten to near death by Rhino, at least on multiple occasions, from what the game confirms. There's even the likes of other villains in the game, like Sandman, okay? Sandman is confirmed in the game, as is Mysterio. So that means he's resisted hallucinogens and has been able to, take attacks from these kind of characters, all right? So yeah, this Spider-Man is also incredibly fast. And actually we'll have to put him at, again, like every other Spider-Man, faster than light speed. He's been able to dodge Electro's lightning, dodge bullets from, the demons. I actually think that's pretty impressive. One, because the demons are, they're not a joke at all. I mean, these guys are capable of, taking out Sable. This Spider-Man is also incredibly skilled as well. Now, it's not confirmed if he has, training from the likes of my boy Shang-Chi, but he's definitely skilled enough to take on the likes of Silver Sable, Taskmaster, even taking on the demons, who are actually full-blown martial artists. Even Mr. Negative, who is a full-blown martial artist. So, yeah, that Spider-Man is incredibly fast. Also incredibly agile, pretty much. He also possesses a bunch of web combinations. He's got web mines, web bombs, impact webs, mining webs. I hope I said that earlier. Let's see. We got web bombs, impact webs, mining webs, standard web shooters. You all should know that. He's got gravity webs. He's also got spider bots he can use to call into battle, and they actually just pretty much blast you until you're KO'd. I think they're concussive blasts and electric webs as well. Did I miss one? Probably did. Hope I didn't. Let me know down below. So, also, we got that Spidey sense, his sensory aura, which is pretty much allows him to map view entire buildings as well. And, well, that honestly, I think that's pretty much it here. This Spider-Man is pretty strong, pretty fast, pretty skilled, and pretty durable. So, first things first, physicality. So, today here, we got two game characters. Honestly, it's not really hard to gauge how strong these guys are, because their game feats do scale from, well, the video games. If you guys played them, or if you guys have watched them, it would make a whole lot of, makes a whole lot of sense when you think about it. But here, yeah, I think it's pretty safe to say here that we got a pretty good matchup here. I think that's pretty safe to say. So first things first, physicality, and we're going to start off with the strength department. Now, Spider-Man is strong, but I got to give the edge to the Hunter. I mean, he's cracking the armor of some of the toughest of the tough monsters here, okay? He's even been able to stagger the likes of giant monsters that have literal continental feats. Even been able to damage them. So honestly, yeah, I would have to say the Hunter definitely gets the slight edge here. Also is more durable than Spider-Man. Now that's not to say Spider-Man isn't going to harm the Hunter in any way, shape, or form. He's definitely going to be able to put a beat down on the Hunter as well. But again, I have to say the edge here does go to the Hunter. Now, when it terms of speed here, definitely gotta say Spider-Man is the faster one out of the two. Don't get me wrong, the monsters in that game are absurdly fast, from pretty much hypersonic speed to faster than light speed. It's just that Spider-Man has shown more impressive speed feats, in my opinion. But other than that, they would probably be close, But I have to say the Monster Hunter definitely takes the Spider-Man definitely takes the slight majority of the of the speed feats here. Definitely takes the edge here. Now, what about versatility? Now, honestly, I could say Spider-Man's webs do give him an edge here, but honestly, these webbings really don't affect people on the Monster Hunter strength level. I mean, they haven't affected Rhino, who I actually believe is on the same level as the Monster Hunter. I definitely would definitely put Rhino and the Monster Hunter definitely equal in my opinion. I think they're pretty close and they're definitely pretty comparable in my opinion. But at the end of the day here, definitely gotta say that no matter how much webbing Spider-Man can throw at him, the Monster Hunter has resisted it, been able to take it, and has been able to get out of it. I mean, there's monsters like Valhazak who have effluvium, which basically entraps the opponent. There's also the monsters like Diablos and other monsters that can trap opponents as well, with like earthquakes, dunes, mud, like Gyarados and Baroth, who pretty much use good substance of mud to pretty much trap the hunter here. So honestly, I gotta say here, I think this is a pretty close matchup. I really think it's a close matchup with the hunter being stronger and more durable, but with Spider-Man being the more agile and probably the faster fighter. That's what I'm trying to say here. He's definitely the faster fighter out of the two. But that's not to say the Monster Hunter is not gonna get any blows in. And the Monster Hunter's weapon of choice, the Blooming Glaive here, definitely is gonna make keep Spider-Man on edge. But what about the what about the webbing? Can Spider-Man actually take away his weapon? I would have said yes if Spider-Man was stronger than him. Now, if he tries to web up the Hunter, I do feel like it's gonna be a Silver Sable moment where the Hunter pretty much uses his glaive to block it, twists him around, wraps the webbing around it, pulls Spider-Man forward, and gets a solid hit in. I actually think that's pretty much going to be the same situation here. Now, yeah, Spider-Man has beaten characters like Taskmaster, has beaten the likes of Silver Sable, has beaten the likes of, let's see here, sorry, I almost forgot, Mr. Negative, Scorpion, who are also very skilled opponents. But at the end of the day here, the Monster Hunter does have experience dealing with monsters pretty much just like Spider-Man. Monsters like Rajang, Barioth, okay? Even the likes of some of the smaller, insignificant monsters are just as agile, or at least close enough. Even the likes of Odo, Garen, and Tobi Kodachi are on the same agility level as Spider-Man. Honestly, Spider-Man would be in big trouble if he faced those kind of monsters. Gotta say here, this is a fun match. I actually think this is a very fun match in my opinion. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video, but at the end of the day here, the Monster Hunter is going to take this. He's stronger, he's more durable, he's fast enough to keep up, and has the better weapon. Spider-Man can definitely claim a few victories here, but I give it the 6 out of 10 victory here to the Monster Hunter. But let me know what you guys think. Please comment down below, like and subscribe, and share with your friends. Also, this marks the end of the Monster Arena and begins the Monster Coliseum. So, yeah, hope you guys are on the lookout for that trailer as well, as that will also be my new intro to all my new videos coming forward, coming 2021. And I hope you guys, stick around. I really appreciate that you guys have stuck around through the Monster Arena, stuck around through my debunks, and stuck around with me for the long haul. Even for 122 subscribers, being a small YouTuber in my opinion, I thank you guys. Thank you guys a lot. So, hope you guys stick around. Please comment, like, subscribe, share with your friends, or don't. I mean, hey, either way, I'm glad you guys just watched this video. So, happy Thanksgiving. Thank you for sticking around with me, and I hope to see more of you guys in the future. This is Legendary Ghidorah, and I will see you guys later. Have a blessed day, and as always, peace.